Fitness is life, really. It's always been part of my life, whether from when I was a kid playing football or cricket or golf even. Sort of started getting into the gym when I was like 17, 18. And then, like I say, it's just sort of always been part of me.
Across the UK, fitness is a fast-growing lifestyle that many people are choosing to adopt. 272 new public fitness facilities have opened across the UK over the last 12 months. One gym in particular has a fascinating story. This gym is known as Peak Power Strength and Fitness. Peak Power Gym opened in 2016 and has been growing rapidly ever since. I met with owner Alex Barwell to learn more about the gym.
I'm Alex, owner of Peak Power Strength and Fitness Gym, but didn't even think about it when I was doing my PT. And then my mate Jake rang me up, absolutely ecstatic, just sort of heavy breathing, like, oh my god, and I was like, what's the matter sort of thing. He goes, well, can you get some money together? And I was like, I've got some savings. Yeah, why? And he goes, let's buy this gym. It's a gym in Stockport shutting down. I've just been around it, it's loads of mint equipment. I've got a unit in Whaley that we can have, that I'm renting at the moment. We can set it up in there. What do you think? Let's do it. I think we should, you know, and just sort of there and then, without even thinking about it, the first thing that came to my mind was just, yeah, let's do it, you know. Loads of people helped us. I'll tell you a story. So it went through, I'd not seen the unit itself. And I said to Jake along the way, you know, sort of thing, what's this unit like? You know, is it big enough? Are you sure it's going to be able to fit? He goes, yeah, it's big enough, you know. It's got a car in there, but a little bit of a hole in the ground, but, you know, we'll fill that up and we'll empty it all out and it'd be sweet. There was three pits, about 20 foot long and about 6 foot deep. Turns out it used to be an old wagon garage, so there's three pits in there as well that we had to fill with rubble and concrete over. So it was a massive, massive job. So literally the process was, starting off, bought the equipment, had the unit sort of there ready and waiting for us. As soon as we got all the equipment in the gym, then that's when the real work started, you know. It took us 6 months to move everything out, to get everything. We stripped all the crap out, what needed to go, which was pretty much everything in there. We had to paint the walls, obviously, like I said, fill in all the pits, paint all the girders. The office we're sat in now wasn't even here. It used to be like a separate thing. So we had to knock all this down, all these offices and changing rooms were built from scratch. All the electrics had to be done, toilets had to be done, sectioned off, matting had to be bought, you know, mirrors had to be put up. It was literally nothing when we started. It wasn't like we moved in and it was, you know, organise the equipment. It was move everything in and then organise and build it up to a level where we could start setting the equipment up, you know?
I then met with Kyle Murray, a fellow friend and attendee of the gym, to learn more about the environment and what it is like to train here.
Hi, I'm Kyle Murray.
I started becoming interested in the gym when I was around 15, 16, in years 10 and 11 at school, studying sports science, so just got my interest from there, really. Definitely not. The way it's come on over the last 2 years has been a massive, massive improvement. It's good training with people that you're friends with, like you wasn't at the start, and your relationships get better and better over the years. I've gained some really good friends outside the gym now, just through coming here. Definitely training with the same person week in, week out, you know your limits, and you need to pass that. I've come on a long way from when I first started, weights-wise, and it's also good for clearing your head and just being more positive after you've been. If you've had a stressful day and coming here and you walk out stress-free with a smile on your face.
What's it like training with a partner who pushes you
think if he wasn't coming in with a partner, pushing you every day, there wouldn't be much point in myself coming. On my own, it just doesn't go down very well and I give up very easily. Where if somebody stood behind you and won't let you put the weights back, then you have to keep going and going until they feel like you've done enough. I've come from benching a plate to benching three plates. I've come from shoulder pressing a plate to three plates on the Smith machine. Deadlifting from two plates to four plates. Bench press has gone from 30s up to getting 8 reps with the 50s and a couple of reps with the 63s. So definitely come a long way.
Following the discussion with Kyle, I met again with owner Alex Barwell to learn about the newly opened sports massages and fitness classes.
What is a sports massage and what does it do for people?
Sports massage is essential for sports performance, for recovery, mobility, flexibility, range of motion, injury prevention, growth, recovery of muscles. When I did my PT, I really did enjoy like the anatomy and physiology side of it, you know, learning about the body, the different muscles and stuff. So it was always something I thought about doing. So I looked into doing the course, did it, and I just enjoyed it straight away. Looking back as when I was a gym user, if I was going to gyms and it had an in-house sports massage therapist there, then I would definitely utilise it. So that's something that I thought about, you know, to put into play. So obviously originally it was first of all get the qualification done. I knew I had a room in the back that was used for a bit of a storeroom that we sort of left unfinished whilst doing the gym up, you know, storing tools there and other sorts of crap. So initially it was just get the qualification booked, you know, get my head down, get studying. I thought I'd wait to complete the course, you know, put all my effort into that before I started in the room. So it was just before Christmas time around New Year's when I started to empty all the crap out and, you know, start to make it, you know, get it looking like a room first, because it looked like a bloody dungeon at first. You got my mates, Elliot, who was a great plasterer, you know, he got him in and plastered it all, so it looking like proper. Got Johnny Ross, my mate, also to help me board up all the electrical bit that needed boarding up, give it a lick of paint, get some carpet put down, you know, get a massage bed and get it looking something, you know, professional. Fitness classes is a great way for people to come, get a workout in, and don't really know what they're doing around the gym. Maybe a little bit shy or a little bit unconfident to come on their own. You know, it's a great place to socialise as well. You know, we have a great laugh here with all the girls and, you know, all the lads and stuff. So yeah, it's just a good way for people to get in, get a workout blasted, get told what to do, get beaten by someone, and, you know, and just have a good time basically. I mean, when we first opened, we didn't even have fitness classes, you know, it was just basically a big, you know, load weights machines everywhere. I didn't even have any areas to do any stretching or anything like that. So it was just a development over time, really, you know, as well as a business idea and just to get more people in, get more girls in and stuff. Because, you know, when we first opened, it had a bit of a stereotype of being a bit of a meathead gym, which I wanted to quash straight away. You know, I do loads of different classes. Started off originally boot camps, which is just circuit-based stuff. Originally used to do it outside in the mornings, battle ropes, tire flips, all that sort of stuff. Then kettlebells was a big one that everyone wants to do. So just, you know, work out with the kettlebell, very aerobic, dynamic, but sort of try to steer away from that whole kettle size sort of thing. Stereotypical little, you know, easy workout. So just try to peak power it up, you know, get a bit more strength in there, use a little bit more heavier kettlebells and stuff, and just put my sort of twist on it. The thing with this sort of gym is it's not like a big, massive chain gym where no one knows anyone, and you're stood next to someone you don't know and getting taught by someone you don't know, and you're going home on your own, arrive on your own. You know, everyone who comes here knows each other. I know everyone by name, everyone by face, and, you know, vice versa. People come here, make friends, you know, and people, you know, people made great friendship from coming to the classes, and just, you know, so that's what I didn't think it would be that popular, but I think because it's such a close community type of family type gym, I reckon that's why they work so well.